learners, welcome back to the channel. So in this video we are going to study the plant kingdom introduction. So right now we are going to start with the system of classification. See, artificial system of classification was based on few criterias. Okay, it was based on few superficial morphological character, like you can say habit, where they are found. Okay, means are they having a herb, shrubs or trees, what habit do they make, what type of color and how many number and shapes of the leaf. Means they were based on only basically vegetative character. Linnaeus was the one who used the androecium character also. So Linnaeus was the one who used the androecium character. This was actually used by the Aristotle. Okay, this was used by Aristotle and Theophrastus, they have used it. So this system of classification is called artificial. Reason is because it is based on only few character and as a result closely related species were separated, you can say. The closely related species were separated because they are giving equal importance to the vegetative as well as sexual characteristic. Vegetative character means like root, stem, leaf, and sexual characteristic like androecium. Okay. Now see the drawbacks of the artificial system. Very important drawback is ki they separated closely related species. Because reason is because this was based on only few character. Reason is because since it is based on only few character, that is why the closely related species are separated. It is based on few character. Okay, and second is ki they are giving important to both vegetative and sexual character. But main thing is this ki vegetative character is getting affected. Vegetative character is changed. You can say it is changing with environment condition. It's changing with environment conditions. So it's better to give importance to the sexual character instead of vegetative character. But artificial system was giving importance to both. So that is why this system of classification is not accepted. Later on, natural system of classification was accepted, means it was given by the Bentham and Hooker, which will be accepted. System of classification, which was given by Bentham and Hooker, what are the criteria they have taken? They have taken many criteria like external structure, we will say morphology. Okay. They are giving importance to internal structure, we will say anatomy. They are giving it to cell structure, means cytology. They are giving importance to embryology. And phytochemistry. Now this is your question area. They are giving importance to phytochemistry. So these two points are your question areas, please. So these are the criteria taken by them and they are trying to establish natural affinities between them. And it is, you can say it is based on natural affinities. This is very important word. They are trying to establish natural affinities. As a result, the closely related organisms were brought together. Okay. So they were trying to establish the natural affinities. Now the book written by Bentham and Hooker was Genera Plantarum. They have written the book that is Genera Plantarum. Up till here, is it clear? Now see how they have done. Bentham and Hooker, flowering plants are divided into three classes, dicotyledon, gymnosperms and monocotyledon. If you check carefully, there is one drawback. According to them, gymnosperm is kept in between the two members of angiosperm. Because they were not following the phylogeny. They tried to establish the natural affinities, but they didn't go for the phylogeny. So this is a drawback of the Bentham and Hooker system of classification, that they have kept the gymnosperm in between the two members of the angiosperms. Now, according to him, the three classes, now right now, instead of classes, we use word division for them. They are divisions. And it is divided into dicotyledon into three subclasses, polypetalae, gamopetalae, and monoclematae, which is divided into three series, polypetaly into three series, thalmi fluoride, calci fluoride, disci fluoride, and gamopetaly also in three series, that is heteromery, infariate, and bicarbolate. Is it clear? So these are the series divided. Monoclimidae has got 8 series. And monocot will have 7 series. So series, right now series is known as a class. According to the taxonomical hierarchy, what we have studied in the previous chapter, series is known as class. Okay, this is right now current. Now each series will have order according to Bentham and Hooker language. We will say they are having order. But order is now known as family. Okay, so I'm writing it here. You can understand I'm writing it. This is a family. It is 6 family, 4 family, 5 family here. Here 3 family, 3 family, and here 4 family. Is it clear? So these are the one which is present according to the Bentham and Hooker system of classification. And biggest drawback of this system is ki they are keeping the gymnosperm in between the two member of angiosperm. So the third system of classification was developed, that is known as phylogenetic system of classification. Is it clear? But still we practice this Bentham and Hooker system of classification to maintain our botanical gardens and to maintain our herbarium sheet. Please learn it. To maintain our botanical garden and to maintain our herbarium sheet, we are still following the Bentham and Hooker system of classification. Otherwise, now we have replaced it and now we are following the phylogenetic system of classification. And our plant kingdom will be studying through phylogenetic system of classification only. Phylogenetic system of classification. So first of all, what do you mean by the word phylogeny? Phylogeny means evolutionary relationship. If you are arranging anything with respect to evolution, then we say we are following the phylogeny. So first of all, this is clear. If phylogenetic means we are following the evolutionary relationship. And this term was given by Lamarck. Clear? And the concept of phylogeny. Concept of phylogeny was given by Haeckel. He has given the concept of phylogeny. I hope up till here you are able to understand. Now, main important line of this, it means organism belonging to same taxa are believed to have common ancestor. They are believed to have common ancestor. I hope this line is very important. You have understood it. They believe to have common ancestor. Is it clear? And the tree which we prepare it to show the phylogeny, that phylogenetic tree is known as cladogram. Phylogenetic tree which we prepare, that is known as cladogram. Please learn it carefully, okay? The tree is known as cladogram. Now we will study the scientists who have contributed in the phylogenetic system of classification. Contribution came by Engler and Prentl. What he has done, first of all, he has done the correction of the Bentham and Hooker system. According to the Bentham and Hooker, right now we discussed, it is following dicot, gymnosperm, and monocot. So what he told first will be gymnosperm. He has done the correction, but by mistake, he kept the monocot as primitive and dicot is advanced. This is again your PMT question they asked in the previous year. According to which scientist, sympetaly condition is advanced? Okay, I'll write the question for you. So according to which scientist, sympetaly condition. So sympetaly condition means gamopetaly. Okay. Sym means fusion of the petal. So gamopetaly. And if you remember in the previous, right now only we have studied, ki gamopetaly we use for the dicot. So sympetaly condition is advanced. So your answer will go what? Your answer will go Engler and Prentl. Is it clear? The scientist's name is Engler and Prentl. So according to him, this is the one he told, ki sympathetic condition is advanced, means Tycot is advanced. Is it clear? Another question which they ask is, which book is written by him? The book written by him was, let me just give you the name of the book, that is Die Nature Lichen, Plants and Familien. Plants and Familien. Okay, beta. If they ask this, then you have to remember this is the book written by him. So again, this is a mistake because later on they identified that Dicot is not an advanced feature. Dicot is a primitive feature. Is it clear? So correction is done by another scientist. Let me show you. Who has done the correction was Hutchison. And according to him, flowering plant, he told gymnosperm will be primitive. There is no change in the position of gymnosperm, but then dicot is primitive and monocot are advanced. Okay, and the book written by him, Hutchison has wrote the book that is known as Families of Flowering Plant. The book name is Families of Flowering Plant. So this is the second scientist who contributed in the phylogenetic system of classification. Is it clear? Now let us see the third scientist. Engler is the one who has given the phylogenetic system of classification for the entire plant kingdom, and we will be following his system of classification to study. So according to him, kingdom Plantae, okay, this is the kingdom Plantae, is divided into two subkingdom. And these two subkingdoms were Cryptogam and Phanerogam. So first of all, this is the kingdom Plantae is divided into two subkingdom. Then it is divided into divisions. Thallophyta, Bryophyta, Pteridophyta. And it is divided into one division that is known as Spermatophyta. So these are the divisions. I hope you are able to understand the diagram. Then Thallophyta is divided into two subdivisions, that is algae and fungi. And Spermatophyta is also divided into two subdivisions, that is gymnosperms and angiosperms. So these are the two subdivisions of Thallophyta as well as of the Spermatophyta. But main thing is this, you know very well, ki fungus is separately created kingdom by the Whittaker. Fungus is separately kingdom created by the Whittaker, but still we are following the phylogeny. That is why we have written it under the Thallophyta. Is it clear? But according to the Plantae kingdom, we'll be focusing, our focus will be on the algae, Bryophyta, okay, Pteridophyta, gymnosperms, and angiosperms. We will not study fungus here because already we have studied separately as a kingdom fungus. So this is the one, now we are going to start with the Plantae kingdom. Is it clear? That the plants have two types of body. N body, also known as gametophyte body. Another is your 2N body, which is known as sporophyte body. Okay. So two types of bodies are there. Plant will show the presence of two type of body. N body, gametophyte body, 2N body, sporophyte body. Now N body means which is haploid body. Okay. It is haploid body. So it will make gametes. That is why it is known as gametophyte. So it will make the gametes by the process of mitosis because body is already haploid. So these are the gametes which they are making it. Now gametes will be fusing to form zygote. This is zygote formation, and zygote will develop into embryo. So zygote will develop into embryo, and embryo will develop into 2N body, which is also known as diploid body, also known as sporophyte body. Okay, it is called a sporophyte body because it is going to produce spores by the process of meiosis. Very important, they will do sporic meiosis. They will make the spore by the process of meiosis. The spore formation is done, which is haploid, and the spore will germinate to form N body. So two types of bodies are there. One is haploid body, which is going to make gametes. One is diploid body, which is going to make spore. Now from this, if suppose I ask you which is the one which is going to give rise to haploid body, then your answer will be spore. Spore will germinate to form haploid body. And if I ask who give rise to diploid body, then your answer will be zygote, which is going to make embryo. If it is making embryo, it will give rise to diploid body. So plants are having two type of body. Please learn it very carefully. Haploid body and diploid body. Is it clear? In the next video, I will be giving you the comparisons of all the five members with respect to the bodies, where you will find haploid bodies dominant, where you will find diploid bodies dominant. Okay, thanks.